CDC estimates that 60 million women living in the United States are live with some form of heart disease.
Yeah, it's the leading cause of death for women here in the U.S. Doctors have wondered if there was a way to catch it before it's too late. For more, we welcome Dr. Marc Gilinoff from the Cleveland Clinic. Talk about these new blood tests and how they can make a difference. It's pretty incredible that a blood test can have all these factors.
Yeah, that you can have that much of a proactive approach.
Yeah. And it's really simple. It's just one tube of blood. And from that one tube of blood, we can predict your 30-year risk of getting heart disease, strokes, heart attacks, things of this sort. The tests themselves have been around for a long time. Right. And there are three tests done on this one tube of blood. Your LDL cholesterol, which is the bad cholesterol, that's the one we've always focused on. Mm-hmm. But if you add that test to a test called the lipoprotein little a, which is just another kind of fat, and then a test called CRP, which is C-reactive protein, that's a measure of inflammation. You put these three things together, get your LDL cholesterol, your lipoprotein little a, and your CRP, and we can predict from that one tube of blood your risk of heart disease before you get it.
Hmm. That's crazy. So is it detecting any underlying conditions like diabetes, which would be a problem with heart conditions?
That's a really good point. And diabetes, for example, will increase this test, the CRP. So it all comes together. We'd, of course, want to know your blood sugar and other things, but the key finding, this is a study in New England Journal of Medicine, which to us is the Bible of medicine. The key to this study in New England Journal of Medicine, I think, has two components. One, put three pieces of information together, and two, the follow-up is 30 years.
Yeah.
So usually we talk about your 10-year risk, what's going to happen in the next decade, which seemed like a long time.
Sure.
But now take a 50-year-old woman who appears perfectly healthy, get this test and say, hey, wait a minute, you're at increased risk. Let's change a couple things so you don't have a stroke or a heart attack when you're 70.
So who can? Can I go now, like in my 40s?
Yeah,
anybody could just
commercial
go to
break. We'll get it done.
Okay. All right. I'm used to taking blood anyway.
That fast.
That's great. Okay.
Just for women? Does it work on men?
This study was only in women, but almost certainly it holds for men.
Okay.
So I'm getting the test.
All right. Good.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Absolutely. And it's easy. But let's talk about some of the symptoms of heart disease. I think it's important to always talk about that, even if you're going to get the test or not, but just to kind of stay active with your health.
And the cardinal symptom, the number one thing always is going to be chest pain. Don't ignore chest pain. If you get chest pain and it comes on and it lasts more than 5 minutes, that's a 911 call. In addition, more subtle signs, like I'm a little short of breath. I didn't used to be. Going up one flight of stairs right now, a year ago that wasn't tough. This year it's tough. That's not just getting old.
Or,
that could
or
be
out
heart.
Of shape. Somebody can be like, I work out.
I saw someone yesterday who said, I had no idea this was my heart. I just thought I was getting old the last 2 years.
Wow.
So pay attention.
Why did it take so long to come kind of figure out the idea to put these together and be able to project so long? I mean, you would think that they would have been able to do that, especially if the tests were already there.
Well, we knew each test individually was important, and there are a bunch of different risk models where we take your height, your weight, your age, your blood sugar, et cetera. This was a new way of putting together older information, and to get 30-year results, we had to wait 30 years. So these blood tests were actually drawn in the 90s.
Oh,
and now we're looking at the women in 2024 and saying, going back to your blood test in 1997, we could have told you, if we knew then, that you were at risk.
Wow. That is,
so it's pretty amazing.
That's a little mind-blowing.
Yeah.
That is mind-blowing. Well, any way to stay active with our health and be proactive. I think we think diet and working out and what have you, but there's more things that are available to us.
Those are the foundation, but still check.
Correct, yeah.
And it doesn't mean if they say, oh, you're good for 30 years, that, oh, you can just start eating chips and junk food either, right?
Yeah, that doesn't mean I want the large French fries.
Right, exactly. I mean, you still have to maintain that. It's just whatever level you're at now, if you maintain that level, you know, you could be good for them.
I think most people are more concerned with and more attuned to getting an oil change every 3,000 or 5,000 miles than knowing, hey, what's my risk?
Yeah.
Worry about yourself, not your car so much.
And the 5-minute oil change is never 5 minutes.
No. But this is literally a 5-minute blood test.
That's awesome.
Faster than an oil change, more important.
And we'll see you on New Day.
Yep.
Coming up a little bit, talk more about this as well. Thank you very much.